You're a long way from home. This is Brazil.
And we are now going to Christ Redeemer. We are going via the bus.
Você fala português, cara.
Mais ou menos.
De onde você é?
No Caribe. Manila? Sim. Trinidad.
Ah, sim. Trinidad? Tobago? Não.
Sim, sim.
Aqui. Aí lá em cima tem o ingresso que todos pagam, tá? Uhum. R$50. Paga pra mim, por favor.
Ok. So basically, the train would have been more expensive. You don't get to see as many things. So. So we arrived at the Donna Mata lookout. It's like halfway up, I believe. So we're gonna see what's going on out here. Entendo. So we have 20 minutes out here and then we'll continue the trail, I believe. One thing I noticed about Rio, everyone is coupled up. PDA is like, that's normal. In Trinidad, I don't think it's that big of a thing. People aren't usually that comfortable with PDA, at least to my knowledge and from what I've seen. But here, everyone is in couples. On your way to the lookout, there's like three stairs that you have to go up. Nothing too major, but yeah, just keep in mind. It's actually pretty cool. I think it's around like 21 degrees Celsius. So it feels pretty cool, not too sweaty. Yeah. But look at this view. You can see the entire city. It almost doesn't seem real to me. I can't even begin to describe it. It looks like it's computer generated. It's so beautiful. So this is the quintessential view when you get to Rio. When you think of Rio, you think of this view. So you have Pau de Açúcar, you have I believe that bay is in Botafogo. Yeah. A cidade maravilhosa. That city in the distance is Niterói. That bridge takes you over to there. It's like the sister city of Rio. You can see the airport, everything from here. Again, it's beautiful. Yeah, there's not too many people here. It's not too crowded. It's pretty quiet actually. I thought it would have been louder than this. But yeah. So that was a nice little stop, a really beautiful view of the city. Yeah, a That's about it. We only have 20 minutes, so we're heading back now. Had to take some nice pictures and so on. But we're going to see the main attraction now. We are going to see a next view basically. And there's a second lookout on the other side of the parking lot. So I'm going to check this one out and see what it has to offer. Imagine riding a bike to come up here. I couldn't do it. And from here, you get a better view of the statue.
So.
And even more views of the city. Yeah, basically, yeah, you can get a better view of like the other neighborhoods like Ipanema, Copacabana, Socorro, Botafogo, Centro. Yeah, pretty cool. You could actually hear people from the ground screaming and so on. Kids, I should say. This view kind of reminds me of like a place in Trinidad. I think it's this Mount St. Benedict. It kind of reminds me of Mount St. Benedict. Yeah. Again, it's really beautiful, and I realize like it's pretty clean, so the people here keep the environment clean for the most part, which is something that I wish we could take over to Trinidad. We have a lot of beautiful places too. It's just, you know, the people. So hopefully things change. Quero melhorar o meu português.
Você fala bem.
Fala bem. Falou bem. So y'all heard that from the source itself. I am now the Portuguese master. So time to head back. We're gonna see the statue itself now, I think. So let's go. A nice little trip. So we have made it to the bottom of the statue, I think. I'm gonna have to take probably like a take back what I said about not sweating. I'm beginning to sweat. So there's guys here that kind of direct you to where you have to go. So there's like this staircase, there's people selling food. Yeah, I think it's just a pretty straightforward walk. So I think this is like, this is a shop. You can buy like souvenirs, t-shirts, etc. before you go to the actual statue. So yeah. think that is where you buy your tickets. So you buy your Simão, head up to the statue. After you get the tickets, you have to pass through like this place here so that you can check it, and then you can head up to the statue. So after this kind of tickets, they will like sign it, and that gives you the okay to now go ahead to the statue itself. So after you buy your tickets, you have to get in like one of these Mercedes Sprinter cars, and they take you up to the statue. It's pretty chill. You have to take off. You don't have to, but it's probably the easiest way. You take these elevators and it takes you straight up there. There's also the option to walk up via the stairs, but I rather it. I think there's a showing as well. I'm waiting. So there's the option to go up to the statue again via an escalator or stairs, but I am choosing to go up via the escalator because I'm already sweating. So up down. Look at this view. And you can see, I think that's the Maracanã. You can see it in the distance. But I think there's going to be a lot of people up there now, so. So it's a lot of people here. That's a little late. Actually, when you come back, it's around 8. Yes, there's people, but that's fine. So many people here, you can't even get a spot to take up or photo. So you had a fight up. Yeah, that's just how it is when you're visiting one of the seven wonders of the world. I'd expect that.
Yeah. Dá pra chegar até aqui de baixo. Daí depois que você ir no Pão de Açúcar, só vai.
Tá vendo? Aqui é meu Pão de Açúcar. O parque tá ali, a encerra de boa. Então, Jorge,
so just now, like this group of girls, I really want to show them on camera because they look like they're like 11. And no, that's weird. But they came up to me and they were like, I look like a singer from Brazil. His name is Matthew. And they're still looking at me. So, yeah. It's crazy. I'll take that as a
this food could be like right now. Anytime this food, that's it. And I'm going to buy what we for right now.
So, we're gonna try pau de queijo and coxinha de frango. I've never had either, so let's see how it goes. A staple in Brazil, guaraná. It's not terrible, but I don't like it. Now go. This is really good though. It's like the Trinidadian equivalent would be something like peri. It tastes exactly like that. And I'm gonna try the coxinha. It's shaped like a cone. É deliciosa. Yeah, this is really good. It's like, imagine a chicken pie, but it's a cone shape. The chicken is like really moist. It's real tasty. And the dough is like made of corn flour, I believe. It's not like, that's really good. So that concludes the trip today. It was really, really an amazing experience. I think everybody should at least come to Brazil once in their life. Yeah, because you guys really want to eat some coxinha. Yeah, so we're gonna head back down the mountain now. There's fans that take you back down. Same way you come up, same way you go down. Yeah, headed back to my place now. Peace.